Yeah. I'm fully focused, fully focused. I got my mind on my money and my money on my mind, and you notice, and you notice. I can make a bitch disappear like this. Focus, 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 and you notice, and you notice. Fully focused, fully focused. I got my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
And you ride for me,
and you know that I'm gon' ride for you.
And you ride for me.
Hey babes, welcome back to my channel. This is Cassandra. Welcome back. So today we're doing the I'm so excited. We're doing the Frozen palette, but this is Elsa. Look how pretty. I've been having to like hide this for my daughter. Well, hold on. So I also got the Frozen Anna one. It looks exactly like this. So these are the two palettes. You're so pretty. And then in the back, it has the names. So, I've been having to hide these from my daughter. Like, hide them. Because every time she sees them, like, online or something, she goes, no, not for you. For me. For Stella. For me. So, I've been hiding these so she won't get a hold of them and swatch them herself or break them. So, I'm super, super excited to actually be trying these on. Today, we're going to be doing the Elsa palette. So, I'll show you that in a bit. But I want to show you before we jump into that. The Anna palette, so it looks just like this. This is Anna. And then hers are like more, I guess more purples and golds. I have this pressed glitter right here is gold. And you got like your purples right here. And then your gold, your brown. And then a very shiny white right here. This is super pretty. I will be doing a look on this later on in the week. I will be using this one. So you guys will be seeing this upload after the Elsa one. Oh! And what I also got, I'm so, so excited, is the Going Coconuts. And this is their 9-pan ones. Oh my god, this one's so, so beautiful. I can't wait to use it. Look at that. Look at how gorgeous this is. And this one I will be using for Thanksgiving. So that this one will be after these two videos. So I'm trying to hit back-to-back-to-back with videos. I'm trying, guys. So hopefully you guys keep being subscribed and watching all my videos. So yeah, this is it. This one's so beautiful. Ugh. I can't wait to use this for Thanksgiving. Okay, so now the Elsa palette. Oh my god, look at this. This is gorgeous. And I love that blue right here. Like, I don't know why, but I'm gonna use this blue. And I can't wait to use it because I'm in love with it. There's something about this blue that's gorgeous. Ugh. So let's just jump right into it. Yeah, so I really, really wanted to see with this blue, maybe these two colors and then this one. I don't know. So let's just jump right into it. So I'm using my favorite MAC 224 brush, and I'm using the color called Fire. And it's like this brown color. Where does it pop that right here? It has like, I don't know, maybe like a little bit of a hint of pink, but very pretty. Or is it my brush maybe? Let me see. Getting a real fluffy brush, and I'm just kind of packing this right here everywhere. Because this is going to be like my base color. And it looks brown, but I feel like it has some pink to it. Let me swatch it. Yeah, so it's like a brown, but it has like a pink tint to it. So it's not as brown as it looks in the pan. But I feel like you guys already know Colourpop always gets me on that for some reason. I always think it's a different color. Okay. Mine right here might be a little patchy right here just because I got my eyebrows done yesterday and I went to a new lady. And like, you know when you do threading, how like it could cut you sometimes? And right here, so I have like some scratches right here, so. Yeah, so right there might be patchy, but that's not because of the palette, but because of my skin has like a little bit of cuts right there. Okay, so now I want to swatch the color called Water. And what is that called? Spirit Lift? Or something lift. I can't. It's because some of, we look in the back, everything's written like in cursive. So I'm trying to see what it says. Spin something? I don't know. Spin diff? Spin fright? Sorry, but it's like this burgundy color. And I want to swatch those right here. Ooh. That blue is pretty and that burgundy is pretty. Those are really pretty. So what do I want to go in with? Let's go in with this one, with the burgundy color. I'm just going to get my thing. We're just going to hit that and put that right underneath. I kind of feel, I don't know if it's just me, but I kind of feel like these palettes are a little chalky and they're not that easy to blend with. Or is it just me? No, maybe just, I think these palettes are a little chalky because I'm not having, like, it's not blending how usually they blend. I like the packaging, but I don't know how I feel about the actual blending of them yet. Like, they're giving me a little bit of an issue. And then, like, right here kind of went in patchy right there, if you guys could see. So I do not like that. And that sucks because I was so excited for this palette. And if you guys know, I think I was more excited too just because it was Elsa. Not because I liked Frozen the movie, but because my baby likes it. So it was kind of like, oh. But I feel like they're a little chalky. They're not so, like, maybe it's just me, but I'm not really liking them. Not a real big fan, but we're going to make this work. I'm using that first color just to kind of blend the shades up there because, like I said, I'm not liking how they're blending. So I'm kind of patting it and then trying to diffuse it. Ooh, I'm kind of scared of going with that blue now, but we'll see. So I'm going to go in now with a tighter brush and I'm going to go back into this and kind of just put this in that crease and hopefully this will also make like that patchiness go away right here. Okay, so I'm just patting that on and then I'm going to kind of do it like that. Maybe it's just this burgundy color that's giving me trouble because like this is only my second color that I'm using, so we'll definitely try it out in a bit. We're gonna try out some other shades so we could get a real good like decision if we like this or not. Okay. So you guys already know I love to cut my crease. Well, today we're gonna do halo eye though. I like to use my little Michael's paintbrush and then my Colourpop No Filter Concealer. So these are like my babes. We're gonna get a good amount. I'm using white just because I want to use more like a silver and a whiter shade, so I don't want no I don't want like the purple to pop out or have like a little tan color. I want it to be more white because I want to get the true color out. Okay. So we have that cut. We did a little bigger on the halo part, but just because I wanted to be a bigger because I want to apply the blue on that inner and outer corner. So I'm gonna use like a real nice flat brush to pack the blue on. Something like this, very flat. I'm gonna get this blue and this is called water. And we're just going to pat this right here. And if my color theory is correct, the blue and the pink should blend into a nice purple that should blend it all together if my color theory is right. You see, I don't know, I feel like it's kind of chalky because right here, it got like patchy right there too. So, this might be too early to say, but I want to say that this is probably not their best palette, like, formula-wise. But if you want to collect it just as a collection, just because it's Anna and Elsa, then go ahead. But is it a palette you need? Is it really blendable? Is it this, that? Personally, for me, no. But I am going to be doing the Anna one still next. And we could see from the Anna one if it's good or not. And then I'm going in with that pink brush and I'm kind of just diffusing that. I didn't put anything really in here. I'm just kind of using like a light hand. And that should work. So just a little bit. And I'm mostly tapping it off. You know, I'm going to go in with the same brush. I'm going to go into that blue and kind of try to bluff it out. Sorry, blend it out a little more. With that blue on there. Oh yes, that helped. Using more like a blending brush. And it did do what I was hoping it would do. It actually created that purple for me. Okay, so what I want to go into now is this color called Ice Crystals. And it's like a silver color. And I want to go into Flurry. And it's like chunky glitter. And I want to use this color, Ice Crystals, with a little bit of chunky glitter on top. So we're just going to wet our brush. And I like using the Morphe M421 brush to pack on shimmers. Because look how nicely it looks when it just packs it on. Oh, so pretty. And we're just going to put this right here. And it's like a blue silver. Oh my god, that just made the look. That honestly made the look so much better. Wow. That literally took the look from like from like a 5 to like a good 8-9. Wow. Wow, okay, that really helped. And I'm gonna use my Anastasia glitter adhesive. And I'm just gonna get just a little bit, and I'm just gonna kind of like softly put a little bit everywhere. And then I'm gonna use the back of my brush and pick up that chunky glitter. And kind of just tap it on. Just a little bit. Like that. Like, I don't want it too much, especially because of my contacts, it always gets in there. But I want to just put just a little bit to kind of give it like a 3D look. You know, I'm pretty sure this would look really pretty without that pink and the purple. And by sure just did it with just blue, I'm pretty sure that would look really pretty too. And then if I got any glitter on top, I'm kind of just cleaning it off. So right here. Or you could use a spoolie like this and just scratch it off. And that will help a lot. Okay, and that like really, really helped the look so much. I'm gonna go into the blue and the purple right here and just kind of blend everything out again. Okay, that is perfect. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to cut this, clean it up, put my mascara, eyeliner, all that good stuff, and we'll be right back. 1, 2. 3. Okay, babes. So I changed my shirt to a different shirt. The other one's a little too much, and just because since the eye look kind of came out more pink and purple with a little bit of blue, I want to put a pink shirt, so I changed that. This is the look. Not really feeling it, to be honest, but I want to upload this video still. I'm going to upload it just because I want you guys to see how I kind of did it, but I feel like the colors are very, very chalky, honestly. They weren't that easy to blend. The glitter kind of went all over the place, like in here, which I don't like. But thankfully, like everyone knows, eyelashes always, always help. They always save the day, eyelashes. So we're lucky for that. Okay, so let's just finish the eye look and then we'll be done. I'm using my cream gel liner BFF from Colourpop in the color Prance. And it's like this really pretty, blue. Look at that. It's such a pretty blue. Oh. I'm gonna pop that right there. I kind of wish the blue more showed on my top lid to bring this out, but it's okay. We'll still bring some blue out. I want to use this palette called Incense Never Give Up on Your Daydream. And the reason why is because it has these really pretty, like, highlighter blues. And I want to try them. I'm going to try this color called Dreamy. We're going to wet our brush. And I want to apply that color, Dreamy, into my inner corner highlight. And it's, like, a really pretty blue. With a little bit of escape. Just because it's kind of lighter. Now we're going to go underneath with the water, and I'm going to use the color Fire. And then we're going to go in with Spirit Lip, whatever, that burgundy color, and blend it out. Let's pop some mascara on and then we're done. Okay, babe, so that's it. This is the look. It looks pretty on the monitor, it does, but I personally don't like this look. I think the formula is very chalky. Didn't like it at all. The glitter smeared everywhere. That burgundy color was kind of hard to blend, but I would say if you really like Frozen or Elsa, you just want to do this for more like decoration or a collection, then go ahead, buy it. But personally, I didn't like it. I had super, super high hopes for it. I really wanted to blend more. The colors were just too chalky. They didn't want to blend too much. I had to kind of more try them more than usual. So I personally don't like them. So honestly, for me, it's not really a must-have unless you want it just for the collection. But I am hoping on my next review for the Anna palette, this one that, you know, it does blend better, I'm hoping. So this will be on my next coming up video that you guys will see my thoughts on this. And I'm hoping it works better than that Elsa one, because honestly, I didn't like it. If I wasn't really leaving, I probably would, I don't know what I think of it, just... Like I said, it looks pretty on the monitor, but I don't like it in person. I don't think it blended that good. But these are just my thoughts. Let me know how you guys feel about the palette. If you guys like it, if it blended for you easily, let me know, right? Love you, babes. Bye.